building. So finding out if you need permits, if you need special permission. Probably want to pick a spot where there's very little restrictions. You definitely want to get a nice south-facing spot. If you're above the equator, if you're below the equator, obviously you want to be north-facing. And then just gathering materials and going for it. So a lot of people on our crew are building their homes for $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 US dollars. Well, because we're a for-profit company, a lot of our buildings are for clients who have saved up money, or they take out a mortgage and they want like the conventional version of what we have. However, we've been lucky enough to go to disaster relief areas such as Haiti. We were just in Haiti. We were in the Andaman Islands in 2005 after the earthquake. We just got back from Sierra Leone in Africa. We built a Waldorf school for children. And that's where I would personally, and I believe a lot of people in the company would like to see this take off, is building very simple and very low-cost housing for everybody, because the average person can't afford all of the conventional amenities as a regular house. We'll build these for people, and they will have the up-to-date conventional modern amenities that an average home will have. I would really like to see a lot more of the simple survival model, where it's just basic primitive living that the average person can afford and have. I think there'll be a lot less wars and a lot more happy people on this planet.
That's all. So if you have some questions, we are here. And we thank you for your attention, and we hope you have enjoyed this short documentary.
Thank you. I think we have seen something completely different within this today presentations, but I think it was a sort of input, a short input, but it is also an issue that is connected to Umberto's also exposition presentation. So. We are talking about how important is the human being, so the person within the whole process of transformation of the economic system, if we want to go into that direction. So the centrality of the human being is at the end the most important element of the whole system. So ownership, participation, connectivity, and so on. So very interesting. Thank you. Now I would like to call Francesca from the Center for Applied Ecology.
So I'm Francesca from CETA, Center for Theoretical and Applied Ecology. CETA is a research center founded in 1987. Is a center in the network of research institutions, national and regional institutions. Members are some public bodies, for example, the two regional universities and private bodies. And we are built on four main pillars, which are the knowledge, the environment, the energy, and the territory. As regard just a very brief introduction about CETA and DAN, I'll go to present you some of the projects in which we are involved, just to give you some examples of the activities we are doing. So, as regard the knowledge, we are engaged in some research projects with special regards to biofuels, small chains, producing biofuels, crops for energy purposes, wind energy, building integrated solar thermal energies. And we aim also, one of our aims is to validate advanced innovative technologies and cooperate with other EU technology and research institutions in order to build up international partnerships. As regards energy, we develop models for decentralized energy production based on low environmental impact sources and energy efficiency, developing suitable technologies, giving technical support to planning activities, and assessing the economic sustainability of each project and planning sustainable management models. As regards the territory, we plan and manage the territory in order to safeguard the environment and its local communities. So one of our activities is to deal strategic planning and programming in the sector of energy, government and territory, and the management of sensitive ecosystems. Some services we give to SMEs and public bodies are mainly SMEs are life cycle analysis, which aim is to reduce the resources used for the production processes, carbon and water footprint, which aims is to reduce the emissions, environmental accounting models, cost benefit analysis, and multi criteria analysis. We are also involved in ecosystem service assessment, and which is also one of the aim of the EU for the next programming period, with special regards to green infrastructures, and finally valorization and conservation of landscapes and sensible ecosystems management. As regards environment, we are involved in requalification, renaturalization, and the pollution of contaminated areas, low environmental impact technology adaption for water treatment, for example, phytodepuration, and the strategies finalized at the reduction of waste production and the creation of green waste and renaturalizations. So some projects, ideas in progress, and in which we are involved in order to submit proposals and the framework of the next programming period are, for example, the eco-industrial park, which is a topic already introduced by some partners during the morning. The table is composed of three columns. The first one is represented by natural ecosystems. In ecosystem, the flows or materials are closed, which means that the output of one level of the chain is the input of the following step. So waste does not exist. And this is the typical ecosystem equilibrium. Industrial systems are based, on the contrary, on a linear model, which means that outputs of a step of the chain could be input of the following step, but sometimes are also represented by waste, which produce polluted water, polluted air, and so on. Eco-industrial parks try to use the approach of natural ecosystems and adopt them in the industrial sector, which means that eco-industrial parks aim to close the flow of the materials also in the industrial chain. So waste of a step could become input of the following step. One of the main simple example could be energy. Energy waste of high intensive energy sector could become the input of a following step. So there are several types of eco-industrial parks, and during the closing programming period, we try to submit a proposal aiming to develop this model among a consortium of industrial areas. But unfortunately, the proposal failed. But anyway, we think that this is could be a very interesting topic also considering the next programming period. And as example of other activities and services that we try to push in order to involve small and medium enterprises, as suggested by EU and in the framework of a low carbon economy, are life cycle assessments, product environmental footprint, carbon footprint of products, and water footprint of products. So some projects in progress. This is a project financed by Central Europe Program, which aim was introduce renewable energy sources and energy efficiency measures in historic buildings. But I bring this project as an example because during a study visit we visited the Gothenburg heating system. And the city, the heating system of the town is based on a district heating system. And what is was interesting in this case is that the fuel for this district system is alimented by 81% from waste heat, which means that otherwise this heat will go in the air, and 15% by renewable energy sources and just 4% by fossil fuels. Well, the results of these heating systems are 60% of the thermal demand is supplied by the district heating system, of which 81%, if you remember from the previous slide, became from a waste heat, which means that in general terms, the 48% of the total thermal demand of the town is supplied by waste heat. There, as a consequence, the town cut the 90% of the CO2 emissions since 1975, and the district heating system is composed by a 22,000 meters pipeline. We are involved also in other projects regarding also natural resource management with also tourist purposes and project trying to involve small and medium enterprises in the terms of renewable energy sources and energy efficiency. As regard the chains for the production of second generation biofuels from crop residues, agro-industrial residues and energy crops, the main is also that to reduce CO2 emission, assess energy balances, environmental balances and economic balances. And only when these three main balances are positive, we suggest to invest in these chains. Just as an example, we are now involved in this project aiming to assess the carbon footprint